My initial approach to number 10 was to restore it with a veneer, but the large gingival embrasure space between number 9 and 10 required me to place my margin more lingually to gain more aesthetics. I used NX3 Nexus 3rd Generation light-cured resin cement to bond the crown onto the prepared tooth, giving me a flexible setting time to correctly position the restoration. The results show that the lab matched the exact shade and shape that the patient had always wanted since she was a child. Hello, I'm Dr. Ginny Bender, and I'm an in-house clinician with Glidewell. This is Justine, who was my patient when she was a child. Many years later, as a young adult, we met again as co-workers at Glidewell. Justine has always felt self-conscious of what she called her baby smile. She desired a more mature and confident smile. Together, we decided to cosmetically enhance her smile by addressing her underdeveloped appearance of her peg lateral number 10 and roughness of the incisal edges of her upper and lower anterior teeth. To create a symmetrical and beautiful smile, her upper and lower anterior teeth were treatment planned for selective minor enameloplasty of number 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, and number 22 to 27, along with conservative cosmetic composite restorations of number 7, 8, and 9. For teeth number 7, 8, and 9, I first lightly roughened up the enamel with diamond prep burrs. Using 37% phosphoric acid etch, I conditioned each tooth for 5 to 10 seconds and rinsed with lots of water thereafter to ensure dentin is left moist. I like to apply gluma desensitizer to seal any potential opened dentinal tubules. It also helps disinfect and re-wet the tooth for the next step, which is the adhesive agent by 3M Scotch-Bond Universal Plus. I scrubbed it in for 20 seconds and it air dried for 5 seconds prior to light cure for 10 seconds. I used Omnichroma Direct Composite by Tokiyama, a resin-based restorative material that can aesthetically match the entire Vide shade with just one shade. I finished and polished with fine diamond burrs and Soflex contouring and polishing discs. I've been using the Soflex system since the 90s and I simply cannot practice dentistry without them. It's so easy to get the line angles, create symmetry, natural shape, and smooth quality back to the teeth. Soflex finishing strips are gently used to remove any overhangs in the interproximal area, being careful not to damage the gingival tissue or precious papilla. If you aren't sure, take a radiograph to make sure. I continue to perform enameloplasty as the cosmetic composite restorations start to take shape. A perioprobe or electronic digital caliper can check the width measurements to ensure symmetry of number 8 and 9. A carbide egg-shaped burr is used to adjust the lingual aspects for ideal occlusion. I recheck with floss again to ensure restorations do not have overhangs. Now that there's symmetry and harmony accomplished through selective enameloplasty and bonded restorations, my attention goes to the peg lateral number 10. My initial approach to number 10 was to restore it with a veneer, but the large gingival embrasure space between number 9 and 10 required me to place my margin more lingually to gain more aesthetics. I decided to include the lingual and plan for a full coverage restoration. To fix the baby tooth appearance of number 10, I decided that Obsidian All-Ceramic would be the most suitable material to satisfy the patient's need for a full coverage crown with lifelike aesthetics. Using long tapered round-ended and football diamond burrs, I prepare the tooth equigingively with a 0.5 chamfer margin to provide enough material thickness and strength. For soft tissue control, a two-chord retraction technique is utilized prior to the digital final scan. Using ultra-dense ultra-pack cord, the first cord, size 00, is for apical compression without hemodent. The second cord, size 1, previously soaked with hemodent, is for lateral deflection. After 5 minutes of compression, the first cord is typically left in the sulcus, and the second cord is removed prior to scanning. In this situation, both cords were removed to get more natural emergence profile during crown design. Once the scan of the prep, opposing, and biter completed, I recheck the prep and occlusal clearance by checking the iTero occlusal gram. It's important to check your scan data acquisition before the information is sent over to the Glidewell IO in Office Fast Design software and design station. Artificial intelligence identifies the margin instantly, as shown by the dotted red line. I checked it and marked my final margins, making sure to view it from various different perspectives. I received a BioTemps Now crown proposal with just a few clicks and made minor adjustments to dial in my contact parameters. Finally, I used my Fastmill IO in-office mill to fabricate the BioTemps Now temporary crown chair side in just a few minutes. Properly fitted BioTemps Now provisionals allow the soft tissue to heal to the shape of the accurate margin. At the next visit, Justine was happy with the appearance and fit. I was happy to see that her soft tissue had been groomed to close the black triangle between number 9 and 10. Together, we determined the desired shade for her final crown. We decided on shade A1 because it blended well with the surrounding teeth. With the patient's approval, we are ready to deliver the cosmetic crown using a bonded adhesive cement protocol. I cleaned the preparation with Pumice Preppy's slurry to remove any residual temporary cement. Then I treated the tooth with a 37% phosphoric acid etch for approximately 10 seconds, followed by copious water rinse for 20 seconds and air dry, leaving the dentin moist. I avoid desiccating the tooth that might cause post-operative sensitivity. I desensitized with Gluma to seal the dentinal tubules and to provide an antimicrobial effect. It also helped wet the tooth to prepare for the 3M Scotchbond Universal Adhesive Agent, which is thinned out and light cured. The inside of the crown was previously etched with hydrofluoric acid by the laboratory to create micromechanical retention. Chair side, the inside of the crown is treated with Silane by Monobond Plus to act as a coupler for the crown to the cement. I used NX3 Nexus 3rd Generation Light Cured Resin Cement to bond the crown onto the prepared tooth, giving me a flexible setting time to correctly position the restoration. Applying gentle pressure with a bite stick helps keep the crown seated in the correct position during the curing process. Tack cure mode is recommended for predictable curing and easier removal of excess cement. I gently removed excess cement with a clean microbrush and scaling instrument. Make sure not to fully cure until the inner proximal areas are cleaned well. Once satisfied, make sure to light cure each surface for 10 seconds to complete the process. I always recheck occlusion afterwards for hyperocclusion after cementation. On the lower arch, I performed enameloplasty on teeth number 22 through 27, contouring the teeth to a natural, more even state. Obsidian glass ceramic restorations can be retained with conventional cements, self-adhesive resin cements, or adhesive resin cements. In this case, I chose bonded cementation because it increases the crown strength. Also, resin cement is very color stable, which makes it especially suitable in the aesthetic anterior zone. The results show that the lab matched the exact shade and shape that the patient had always wanted since she was a child. The aesthetic appearance of the obsidian crown exceeded her expectations by blending naturally with her surrounding dentition. This case report demonstrates how digital chairside workflow can simplify aesthetic cases. The ability to scan a patient, design a crown, and mill a provisional chairside and easily deliver the restoration allowed me to personalize the treatment plan with greater flexibility, resulting in a beautiful result. I was so happy to reconnect with my former patient to deliver a brand new smile.